And we begin tonight with an NBC 15 News reality check. Alabama criminals let out of prison early.
It's such a problem here. The governor recently put a hold on parole for violent criminals. Mobile has a new example of those parole problems. Patrick Johnson.
He was sentenced to 10 years in prison. He did just a few months of that, was put back on our streets, and is now accused of murder.
NBC 15's Muriel Bailey spoke with Mobile County District Attorney Ashley Rich about this. Muriel?
Kim Johnson was sentenced to 10 years, but was paroled just a few months later and received years of good time credit. 23-year-old Patrick Johnson is charged with murder and two counts of attempted murder after a shooting over the weekend on Raven Drive. He's behind bars, but this isn't his first, second, or third time.
He has total 10 felony arrest. He has 3 felony convictions on his record.
In February of 2012, he was arrested and charged with robbery and shooting into an occupied car. He was put on probation. Later that year, in December, he turned himself in for probation revocation. In 2014, he was sentenced to 10 years for possession of a controlled substance. He was paroled after just a few months, receiving years of good time credit despite 2 separate parole violations. According to the National Corrections Reporting Program, Alabama has one of the most generous good time laws, with prisoners receiving 2.5 days for every day served. District Attorney Ashley Rich says the problem is with the Board of Pardons and Parole.
In my opinion, we should have truth in sentencing in the state of Alabama, meaning if you get a 10-year sentence, you should serve 10 years. Okay, that's always been my position. I don't think you should get credit for good time. And if you add on the fact that this guy had a bunch of prison disciplinaries, meaning he was acting up while he was in prison, I don't think you should get credit for any good time.
She says if Alabama had truth in sentencing, Johnson would still be in prison serving out his 10-year sentence. Earlier this year, Johnson was charged with bringing contraband into prison. He was out on bond for that when he was arrested this week. Police are also looking for Miles Caples. They say he helped Johnson carry out that deadly shooting on Raven Drive. Johnson's bond hearing is set for tomorrow. Rich says she has requested that he be held with no bond.